All right, this is gonna be sports with the plastic cup, boys. A couple things to talk about, man. Of course, for me, it's the NFL. There's some great NFL topics to discuss. Julio Jones helped land Todd Gurley to the Falcons. Have you guys heard about this yet?
Yeah.
What do you guys feel about that combo, first of all?
We got to see what Todd Gurley got left in his tank.
I don't think Todd Gurley done. You think he's done?
Man, he ain't do shit last season.
I mean, last season was a season that he was basically hurt, though, for the first time.
Huh?
I mean, that was like his real injured season. Like, the other one, he was injured, but didn't he come back? Like, he played hurt a lot last season, didn't he?
No, the season before he played hurt a lot.
Ah, okay.
Last year, he rode that bench a lot.
Yeah, he rode that bench a lot last year.
He got another running back that they liked more. So,
got it.
I think that Atlanta's done. I don't think they're going to be good again for a minute.
Really?
Yeah.
What
did Dice do last year? He didn't do shit, did he?
Who?
Matt Ryan.
Nah, he ain't play good last year.
Yeah.
Might be a wrap for him. They might need to pick up Cam.
I mean, what do you guys think about Cam now with the video in the gym, gospel music playing in the background, working out? What anything from that?
I didn't see that, but that's hilarious. Where does he go? Where does Cam go? I don't know a team they play for.
Redskins would be a good fit for it.
They just picked up two quarterbacks, didn't they?
They had Dwayne Haskins, but he didn't really do shit last year. He could use 2 years to develop.
The Redskins picked up Carolina's other quarterback.
Well, release him. You got the starter now.
And they still got Alex Smith.
I mean, the only other place that I would say you guys are going to – is Baker Mayfield the real deal for the Browns?
They still going to give him another shot. They'll give him another
too
shot.
Too early.
Yeah, too early.
I'm saying if Cam is in a position
– too early.
I know that, but I'm saying, do you bring Cam as your backup?
You don't bring a Cam Newton as your backup to put that kind of pressure on Baker, like you ready to replace him?
Yeah.
You could bring him somewhere and let him compete, or maybe a team that's about to draft a high pick for quarterback is a good place.
Yeah, you've been taking your bum ass team. Ain't like that quarterback to stand the season.
Mm.
Ooh. Yeah.
First of all,
hey, relax, bro.
You need to relax. Okay.
I'm sorry. When last time he played 16 games in one season?
Hey, man, listen, man. That one.
I just asked you a question.
His last injury wasn't on him, bro. It was a helmet to helmet hit, man.
Yeah, it was a.
Oh, because everybody don't wear a helmet for the NFL. Hey,
well, what about like Miami? Were they about Miami or Detroit? Were they about to draft a quarterback or Cincinnati, and then they could come in and be an understudy?
What about the Patriots?
Nah. Not a good fit.
What about the Chargers? Did they pick up somebody? The Chargers?
They got Tyrod.
They got
Taylor.
Taylor?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, he's not going to start all season.
He did good. Where was he at? Buffalo?
Nah,
he got a spot ring.
Nah, it makes sense, though. Like that Miami. Somebody like that makes sense.
What about somebody about to draft a quarterback that can come in and like the dude from Alabama, Tua? What's his name?
Yeah, Tua.
He about to be. They say he might be the first or second pick between him and Burrows.
Who got the number one pick?
Is it Cincinnati?
No, it's the Dolphins, right? No, not the Dolphins.
I'm surprised. Isn't it normally the Raiders? Are you sure it ain't the Raiders?
The number one.
Yeah, the Raiders never shit. So I don't know how they don't have a number.
Brother, don't worry about us. We doing okay.
Oh, you might be right. I think it might be like Cincinnati or some shit.
Yeah, I'm about to go to the what's the name of
that? So what about our boy Jameson? Where he gonna go?
Fuck.
He'd be a good fit in New England.
You think so?
I like him over Cam in New England. I like him over Cam in New England.
Yeah.
Yeah, I do too.
All he needs is that discipline. So he won't throw 30 interceptions.
Right. Yeah, Cincinnati got the first pick. The Redskins got the second pick. Then the Chargers got the third pick.
Yeah, that's why Joe Burrow is definitely the number one pick.
Yeah,
that's already quarterback.
They say Washington getting quarterback and the Chargers.
Washington, why would they get a quarterback? They drafted one last year. They got Alex Smith there, and they just picked up another one. That don't make sense.
They don't have faith in that young dude.
Nah, Joe Theismann told them to take old boy from Ohio State, Chase.
Chase.
Yeah, he was like, yo, two or not right. He's like, I don't believe it.
Dude, you bring up a good question, though, about Winston. Like, where does Winston go?
That's tough.
Where does Winston go?
I'm going to start that journeyman career.
Already?
It's about to be a year here.
But where? I'm saying, where does the first year start? Where does the first year on a journey start? Like, what team is a good fit for Winston or
one of the niggas are going to end up in Philly. Y'all need a backup quarterback.
Yeah. I like Jameis Winston going to the Patriots. I would like to see that, because then, first of all, that's a good pickup for them, and then that also shows how good of a coach Belichick is. If he can turn Winston into like a playoff, league-leading quarterback, that'd be a great look for him.
I mean, look, Winston had some really good years in Tampa.
No, he didn't.
What are you talking about, B?
I didn't say winning years, quarterback performing years. Like, he threw the ball well.
B, he led the league in interceptions.
Yes. First season was probably his best season.
He had
everything.
He showed some great potential.
Do you know he had 30 interceptions? And they said he had another 21 that should have been intercepted that were like dropped. Right. And they showed him. Right. And these were like, not like would have been an amazing catch interception. These were like, yo, how the fuck did you drop that?
Hit him in the numbers.
Yeah.
So you say it's over for him. You say it's over
for him. I say he needs to go to New England. Anybody else is going to let him play out of control like he's been playing, his career is done.
Jesus.
His career not done. He'll just be a career backup.
Which means your career is over.
Means you're done.
You'll be a career clipboard holder.
Yeah, you still getting the check.
Let's go to news with Joey.
Joey Wells reporting live from the other side of life.
Joey.
Okay. All right. With my news today, we actually touched on a few of them already. In fact, I think we touched on all of them.
Damn. All right. Well,
we did. All of them. Except the only one we didn't touch on, man. No. Yeah, we did. We touched on all of them because they were all about the COVID.
you can talk about your son practicing social distancing on Instagram Live. There were only four people in there.
He had about 500 people in there. It was 500 people in there.
Yeah, you must have paid $4.99 to get up in that bitch.
Or 30. Wait, here's the thing.
Email blast you had to send out.
Hey, man. Yeah, it's a tough one.
My log in that bitch, I seen.
Oh, you did it?
Pictures out there. Let me get out of here before you try to give me a shout out.
Come on, man. He got to build it.
What do you guys think about the lives that they're doing with the artists that Swiss Beats and Timberland started?
That's dope.
Which ones did y'all see?
I saw Timberland and Swiss.
That was good.
Then after that, I saw Dream and Sean Garrett. Then the other day, we just saw Neo and John Tech.
That's the one I saw.
What were they doing? They were singing or just talking?
Nah, so they're all singer-songwriters. So they were just having a battle of their, like, classic song. So they would just play back and forth.
Mm-hmm. You play your hit, then I'm going to play mine. Play your hit, then I'm going to play mine.
Naeem, since you're an R&B dude, look at your ROS at the bottom. I got the list of the songs that they went from back to back. Just look at it and who you think won. Because a lot of people saying John Tay won.
I mean,
I don't see it.
It's on the screen. It's
on the Spank tweets. All the way at the bottom.
But nah, Dream funny as shit.
Who is Jonta?
Writer out of Atlanta.
Yeah.
Yeah. Here, writer.
He's a big time writer.
He dropped the album before though. I think he dropped the EP before or something like that.
I think that what it did was take, what I like about it is that Swiss said something really dope. He said, this is an opportunity to give a lot of these artists that are behind the scenes as producers, EPs, a chance to get their roses and flowers now. Yeah. Celebrate them. So you see how Naeem is like, who's Jante? where after this, everybody saw who he was and how much he's done.
Man, he wrote Sweet Lady for Tyrese at the age of 15. I said, God damn.
Insane. Insane.
He wrote a lot of shit, though. That's dope as hell.
He was 15?
Oh, he wrote We Belong Together? Yeah. That's one of my favorite songs right there. Okay.
We got some shit.
That's what he said. He was like, they say this is the number one R&B song ever.
Ever, yeah, all time.
What?
We belong together.
Yeah, no, that shit, the only thing that passed it on number one was the horse. What's dude name?
Lil Zane.
Lil Nas X. Nas X. Yeah, Lil Nas X song passed We Belong Together as the number one single of all time. Well, number weeks at number one. Yeah, on the list.
Either way, I think that Neo's still cracking. I think it was a
no, it was good. That's what like Neo said, like, yo, it was ain't no like losers in this. Like right, that was a win for the culture.
But a lot of people was picking John Tay over Neo because they said Neo's a performer, so you knew all the songs that he wrote. You didn't know what John Tay wrote, so you was being surprised by he wrote for Aaliyah, he wrote for Beyonce, he wrote for
right. And Neo put up some of his own songs.
Yeah, right. You know what I'm saying? Like half
of them. Neo put up a lot of his, but he said he was like, yo, if you want to bet on somebody, bet on yourself.
Yeah.
That's why he's driving his joints.
Yeah, that's true.
I thought Bryson Tiller wrote all his own shit. I didn't know that.
What about what'd you think about Dream and Sean Garrett?
I think Sean Garrett let you know that Molly is still a thing out here in these streets.
Wait a minute, man.
That motherfucker mouth was going 1,000 miles an hour. Then the motherfucker kept getting close up in the screen.
Wait.
And yo. Give me the other Cartiers. The ones with the diamonds in them. Yeah, Dream. You ain't got these the Cartiers the diamonds. Dream said, what? Did you see the beginning of those bank?
Yeah, just a little bit of the beginning.
In the beginning, right? So Sean Garrett just talking all crazy, but you know, it's like listening to your drunk uncle. So fucking Dream got a nigga holding the phone while they on live. So the nigga just follow you like, yo, what the Dream doing? He just walking through the house. Next thing you know, he go out back. He got a little golfing range out there. This playing golf while Sean Garrett tried to explain to him.
Oh, yeah.
This, but it was this and that. He's like, yo, look up. He's not even paying attention to you. This nigga over there playing golf. So when he played his first song, you see whoever was holding care like, yo, he done. So he's like, oh, he finally done? All right. He came back and went in the fucking in the studio. But like, yo. The level of disrespect, like he paid this no fucking mind.
Did they not get along?
It's something in there, yo.
And, you know, they made it seem like, yo, you know, it's all love, my brother, blah, blah, blah. But Sean Garrett definitely said some shit like Dream wear other niggas chains and all kind of shit. So Sean Garrett definitely got slick out the mouth.
Sean definitely said, the reason why you over there with Roc Nation and them and writing songs for them is because of me. And you went over there and you shit on my name. I said, damn. So it's definitely some underlying shit going on with them.
They like Naeem and Harry.
Yeah. I know they both were from Atlanta.
Yeah. That's what it's like. Naeem and Harry.
Ever since Naeem asked about that goddamn tattoo on the chain or something. number four. That's when my grandmama died.
I just asked a question.